We come against every traditional spirit right now. Father God, we every come up against every spirit of religion. Father God, we come up against every form of godliness. Father God, we ask you right now to reign mightily in this place. Father God, we give you the glory. We give you the honor. Father God, we ask you right now, God, to have your way in this place. Father God, we bow the hands of Satan right now that come to seek, kill, and destroy. The ministry must go forth in the name of Jesus, God. Y'all need to help me pray. Father God, we thank you right now, God, for we understand, God, that it's the time that we begin to put the icing on the cake. But God, we ask you right now, when you said in your word, add to your faith virtue unto virtue, all knowledge unto knowledge. Temperance, God, as we look around, we understand here at this hour, something is missing. Something is missing. But Father God, as we stay in alignment with what you're doing, Father God, let us move into what you call us to do. Let me decrease and you increase. Stir up every gift right now. I speak to every word that comes forth out of my mouth, that it may do what you have sent it to do. Heal, deliver, set the captive free in the precious name of your son Jesus. And we give you glory, honor, and praise. Let somebody shout glory up in this house. Oh, come on, shout like you mean it. Shout like you mean it. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, say, come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. I understand that you have a different assignment, but I wish that somebody would realize that it's time to go in. I want Sister Andrea to come and get up. I want you to read. Get your Bible. I need you to read something. And on today, I give honor to the angel of this house. And let me just say this to you all that is in leadership on today. I honor you. I see Pastor Austin back there. Honor her. Amen. Amen. All the ministers, amen, woman of God, I honor you on today. Yes. The angel, as I say, of this house, Pastor Brian. Amen. Elder back there in the back. Yes. And also Elder Sharon, who stepped out. Amen. I see Brother back there, Elder. And truly all the other ministers, and most of all, I honor my better half, Evangelist, elect lady. Amen, 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 amen. And I thank God not to overlook my new found friend. Amen. Look, she tried to hide all the way from Ringo, Virginia. We honor you on today. Amen, amen. With all the preliminaries done out the way, and I just want to say happy belated birthday to my aunt. Look at her sitting there. I said, Lord, she getting old. But she's still kicking. Ain't God good? Come on, let's give God a hand praise. And Sister Andrea, where you at? Where you at? I want y'all to go with me in the book of 2 Peter. I want to just bring this word on today to put the icing on the cake. I was sitting there. I was thinking as every minister went forth, every teacher in their own right, and I rebuke everything that deny who they are in God, because we all are called to witness. Yes. Amen, amen. So I say unto my mother as well as to my auntie, you know, sometimes we don't carry a title, but what's in you is in you. Come on, somebody. And then once you hear this word today, you're going to recognize that sometimes when we come to where we at in ministry, we just got to recognize what God does. Amen. We can't be judgmental or who the messenger is. We can't be bitter about what has transpired. Come on, somebody. Because Paul said, I'm forgetting those things which are. But you can sit there and sit down on me if you want to. You can act like that you got it all together. But you're going to find out today that what I'm talking about in the body of Christ, right today, we have some hand-baked cakes. You got a lot of half-baked cakes in the house of God. Not only half-baked cakes, you got half-baked deacons, half-baked preachers too. But you can't put icing on something that is not done. It's time to go back in the oven. Come on, somebody. Because even though in this time that we're living in, persecution gonna come. The Bible says in Peter, in 2 Peter 1, what it says, add to your faith. Virtue. You there? Come on, because I got to hurry up. Come on. Roll with me. You know how we do. Come on. 1 Peter, come on. 2 Peter. I'm in 2 Peter, yes.
Okay, what chapter?
Go, go.
Okay, I see it. And besides this, giving out diligence, add to your faith.
Add to your faith.
Virtue.
Unto virtue knowledge.
Unto knowledge temperance.
Listen to this. Godliness. Come on.
Into godliness, brotherly kindness.
Come on.
Into brotherly kindness, charity.
Uh-huh.
If these things be in you.
Yeah.
Come on.
And abound.
Watch this. You just can't have it and it ain't doing nothing.
Yeah.
We don't mix all the ingredients together, but see, one thing about the ingredients, they got to cohere one with another. And we got a lot of folks set up in church saying we are the body of Christ, but we can't get along with one another. I want to talk about some half-baked cakes. Walking up in church saying you are the call of God, but you can't speak to one another. Sitting on the same pew and you can't say hello. Who cares what happened on last year? I'm stepping into a new season. Half-baked cakes. In the book of Hosea, we hear God began to speak to the children of Israel about a man named Ephraim. And this is what I want you to understand. Ephraim had slipped in among the rest of the people. But you can't hide in the house of God. God looked down and he saw Ephraim with Israel. And what he said, Ephraim had mixed himself among the people. But Ephraim have not yet been turned. See, half-baked cakes, you turn on one side. But God got to flip you over on the other side. You trying to put icing on something that is not even fit to be eaten. And you setting up in God's house acting like you got it all together. Half-baked cakes. Speaking in tongues, shouting out over the church, but you don't got no substance. It ain't nothing in you. The oil has not generated with the flour. The flour has not came together with the salt, because one got to work one with another. How can I say to Pastor Brown, I have no need of you, and if we are connected to the same body? The devil is a lie. You wonder why a lot of saints setting up in your church still sick. Because you're trying to feed them up yourself and you ain't right yet. You're trying to get a slice off of your book, but you have not been through the fire yet. The anointing is what destroys the yoke. Everything that it come in contact with. We got people shouting all over the church on Sunday and living like the devil on Monday. And then coming to Wednesday Bible study, speaking in tongues, shouting, one in the wall, and living in the church at the same old time. Half-baked cakes. The church is full of half-baked cakes. You look deep on the outside, pulling up in your nice Cadillacs. You got everything that qualifies you to be a preacher or whatever title you want to carry. But what's on the inside is not matching the activity that you have going on the outside. How can you cuss your wife or your girlfriend out on one day and then get in the church and say, oh, I got to pray it out? No, you should have prayed before you open your mouth. Half-baked cakes. I'm bringing it in. I'm bringing it in because the Bible says, add to your faith virtue. Unto virtue knowledge. And if these things be in you, watch this. You got